in terms of technology and evolution, I think there have been some wonderful things. You know, we're able now to take my students in an introductory class into an immersive virtual reality facility. My God, I can take them to Mars. I have in my class samples from the moon, which they sit there and they look at and they piece them together to reconstruct the history of the moon, for crying out loud, real rocks from the moon. I was very inspired by Professor Tim Mudge here at Brown, and he said one time, there's just no more fundamental problems in this field. He was quite right. It was in a kind of a plateau at the time, and he got the idea of applying all that to understanding the planets, which was like revolutionary at the time. So we ended up creating a course in applying remote sensing to other planets, and it was phenomenal. Two out of the three people in that graduate class went on to careers in planetary science, which didn't exist at the time. One day I looked at the College Placement Annual, which is this book that has all jobs listed in it, and I looked up geology, and it had page 15 to 27 and 46. And I thought, what's on 46? It was just a picture of the moon, and it just said, our job is to think our way to the moon and back. It had a little telephone number in a corner. So I called the number, got the job, and went immediately to NASA headquarters as soon as I graduated. If you really want to understand how things work on other planets, you can actually study them here in detail. Antarctica is a very cold, very dry desert. It is so much like Mars that, you know, when I'm down there, I've been down there five seasons, and, you know, you feel like you're on Mars every day. Being able to really experience a lot of different things, this is what helps us understand things. You just have to go out. You have to read broadly. You have to experience things broadly. You have to go to other countries to see how other people do things, to get perspective on that. And I think that's what really is the electricity. And I think you need to daydream a lot. You know, you just need to sit back and look out the window and let your mind wander. You know, you've got an incredible instrument in there, and you know, you just need to let it do its thing. Unleash whatever capability my students and myself have in there that I don't even know how to define, and probably neuroscientists don't yet either. Brown is really an amazing place for a variety of reasons. I always ask students, why did you come here? They will say, well, Brown honors your interests and choices. They know that, okay, and it's the new curriculum, it's all these other things. It's the old university college mode. It's the fact that so many undergraduates are engaged in research and publish papers. The My Lab undergraduates will actually help mentor the graduate students and vice versa. They'll ask the questions, why is this? And the grad students will be maybe a little too professional to ask some of those really fundamental questions. But they'll get going back and forth, and it's just amazing. We're not really teaching people. We're taking these basic capabilities, and of course we give them information and provide them resources and things like that, but the key is to awaken in them their native talents, because everybody has them. It's really important to do everything you can to unleash that, because that's where the future is. This was the beauty of the Apollo program. Imagine 400,000 people, all with a common goal. Nobody said, oh, you're such a jerk. No, it's like, if anybody started to do that, they'd be like, hey, we're launching next week. We don't have time for this stuff. You know what I mean? It was incredible. You know, it's like amazing. And it just showed how with a common goal and, you know, putting pettiness where it belonged, which isn't, you know, is at the bottom of the stack, that you just, you can do almost anything. Go to the moon, for Christ's sake.